Hi children, good morning everybody. So we are going to see the continuation of our supplementary The Tempest. So what we have seen in the last class, we have seen that Ariel, Prospero is commanding Ariel to bring Ferdinand in front of him. Okay, so by his order, Ariel is bringing Ferdinand in front of Prospero, that is, he is bringing a Ferdinand to the island. But Ferdinand is extremely wondered, surprised, because he couldn't because Ariel is invisible to Ferdinand. Okay, but he could hear only the voice of the Ariel. So after reaching the island, he is seeing Miranda. He is wondered by the beauty of Miranda, and he is thinking that she might be the goddess of the island. And Miranda too is equally wondered, because she has not seen any other human being except her father. Okay, so she is thinking Ferdinand to be a spirit. Okay, so now Ferdinand wants to check the constancy, that is the faithfulness of Prospero wants to check the faithfulness of Ferdinand. So he is giving some test for him, that he has to drink sea water, eat shellfish, withered roots, like that. Okay, so when Ferdinand is resisting, opposing this, Prospero, with the help of his magic stick, he is stopping him in that place. Okay, so in the last video we have seen till this. Now let us continue. Miranda hung upon her father, saying, "Why are you so ungentle? Have pity, sir. I'll be his surety. This is the second man I ever saw, and to me he seems a true one." Okay, so Miranda hung upon her father. So she is begging, she is requesting very deeply to her father, telling, "Why are you so ungentle? So why are you behaving so ungentle? Why are you not expressing any kindness towards Ferdinand? Have pity, sir. So have some sympathy on him. I'll be his surety. So I am very sure that definitely he is not the spy. Okay. This is the second man I ever saw, and to me he seems a true one. So this is the second human being I am seeing next to you, that is next to Prospero. This is the second human being I am seeing, and to me he seems a true one. So I think he is definitely a true person. He is not a spy." She is requesting her father, Prospero. "Silence," said the father. So her father is telling very strictly, "Silence. One word more will make me chide you, girl. Okay, if you speak one more word, definitely I'll give you a very severe scoldings." So chide means a scolding very severely. Okay, so if you speak one more word regarding Ferdinand, I'll scold you very severely. "What, an advocate for an imposter?" Okay, so what is mean by imposter is a person who pretends to be someone else in order to cheat, in order to deceive, in order to cheat others. It means vera oruthra maadhiri nadichu yemaathravangala da enna solluvom, we call them as imposter. So here Prospero is telling Ferdinand as the imposter, because he is telling his daughter that he is acting like a spy to plunder to take the island from Prospero. "You think there are no more such fine men, having seen only him and Caliban?" Okay, so he is telling her daughter, "Do you think he is the only fine man? Vera yaarume avana maadhiri beautiful ah irukka maatanga, nalla irukka maatanga nenachittiya. Having seen only him and Caliban," because you have seen only him and him means here it is not Ferdinand. Okay, who is this? Him refers to Prospero. Okay, so understand clearly. Miranda had not seen any other human being except her father. Okay, And also, she thinks no, all the human beings will be looking like her father. So, looking like her father means like looking very old with grey beard, white hair, wrinkled skin, like that. She is thinking that she is having an imagination that all the humans, human being will be resembling her father. And also she had seen Caliban. Ariel is invisible to Miranda. She had seen Caliban. So Caliban is also an ugly monster. Can you remember? Caliban is an ugly monster. So Caliban is also looking ugly. And her father Prospero is also a aged person. So she had not seen any other beautiful men. That's why Prospero is telling her daughter, you think there are no more such fine men, having seen only him. So here him means Prospero and Caliban. This he said to prove his daughter's constancy, and she replied, my affections are most humble, I have no wish to see a goodlier man. Okay, so this why he is telling this is, listen here. So Prospero already knows very clearly that Ferdinand is the son of King of Naples. Why he is testing Ferdinand? This is all a test to Ferdinand to check his quality, to check his character, to check his faithfulness towards Prospero and Miranda. Just he is keeping a test to check Ferdinand. Now he wants to check her daughter Miranda. This he said to prove his daughter's constancy, and she replied, my affections are most humble. So what is the reply of Miranda is, my affections are most humble, I have no wish to see a goodlier man. Okay, I don't wish to see any other good man Ferdinand. Okay, so I don't have any other wish to see a beautiful man more than Ferdinand. Whose this reply is? Can you understand? So Miranda enna solrana, Ferdinand vida or better looking man na paaka aasapadala, I don't wish. Okay, come on young man, said Prospero to the prince. So who is the prince? Ferdinand is the prince. Come on young man, said Prospero to the prince, you have no power to disobey me. You don't have any power, any authority to disobey me. That means definitely you should obey me, obey my rules. So Prospero is telling to the prince. Who is the prince? Ferdinand is the prince. Okay. Prospero had commanded Ferdinand to pile up some logs of wood. King's sons not being much used to laborious work, Miranda soon after found him almost dying with fatigue. Alas, said she, do not work so hard. My father is at his studies. He is safe for these 3 hours. Pray rest yourself. Okay, listen. So what is the order work given by Prospero to Ferdinand is, Prospero had commanded, ordered Ferdinand to pile up some heavy logs of wood. Okay, to pile up. So to collect and file some heavy logs of wood. Okay, so the work given by Prospero to Ferdinand is, he had to collect some heavy logs of wood. Heavy wood, and he has to collect and pile it. King's sons not being much used to laborious work. Okay, so he is the son of a king, King of Naples, right? So king's son will not be, so prince, all the prince will not be doing laborious work. Laborious work means the work which makes one feel very tired. Okay, so no king, no king's son will be doing very such a hard work, right? So Miranda soon after found him almost dying with fatigue. Okay, so as per the order of Prospero, Ferdinand is collecting and piling woods. Okay, so while he was doing this work, Ferdinand is doing this work, Miranda is finding Ferdinand to be dying with fatigue. Fatigue means feeling extremely tired, very, very, very tired. "Alas," said she, "do not work so hard." So don't work. So Miranda is telling to Ferdinand, "Do not work so hard. My father is at his studies. Don't do such a hard work for a long time because my father is in his studies. He is safe for these 3 hours." Who is safe? Ferdinand is safe. Why? Because Prospero is in his study room. So for the next 3 hours, he won't be coming out. Okay. "Pray rest yourself." Okay. So take rest because you are safe for the next 3 hours. As my father is in his studies, he will not be coming out for the next 3 hours. So you can take rest. Who is telling to whom? Miranda is telling to Ferdinand. So now you might have a question here. Why Miranda is so much affectionate to Ferdinand is because she had not seen such a beautiful human being. Okay, so immediately after seeing Ferdinand, both of them are falling in love with each other. Okay, so that is the reason why she is so affectionate to Ferdinand. "Oh, my dear lady," said Ferdinand, "I dare not. I must finish my task before I take my rest." So what is the reply of Ferdinand is, "My dear lady, I dare not. So I don't bother about all this works. I can do this. I must finish my task. So definitely I should finish my task. Task means work. Before I take my rest. So before taking rest, definitely I should complete my work. If you will sit down," said Miranda, "I will carry your locks the while." But this Ferdinand would by no means agree to. So what Miranda is telling is, if you will sit down, so please sit down for some time, I will carry your locks the while. So take rest for some time, I will carry the locks, I will do the work for you. But this Ferdinand would by no means agree to. But Ferdinand is not agreeing to do this. Okay. Okay. So let us stop this class with this. Now let us go for the next one. Okay, now let us see how to answer the passage comprehension questions. Okay, so passage comprehension carries 5 marks. Let us see how to answer the passage comprehension questions. Your sentence should be without any grammar mistakes to score 5 out of 5, right? Listen, see, this is the passage given in your lesson. Okay, so they lived in a cave made out of a rock. It was divided into several apartments, one of which Prospero called his study. There he kept his books, which chiefly treated of magic. By virtue of his art, he had released many good spirits from a witch called Sycorax, who had them imprisoned in the bodies of large trees. These gentle spirits were ever after obedient to the will of Prospero. Of these, Ariel was the chief. Okay, now let us see how to answer the questions. See, listen, what is the first question? Where did they live? Okay, listen to the tense first. What is the tense here? Past tense. So what is the verb here? Did plus live. Okay, did plus live. So what is did plus live? Did plus live is lived. Okay, so where did they live? They lived in a cave made out of a rock. See, in your book, what is the line? They live in a cave made out of a they lived in a cave made out of a rock. So no problem here, you can write as it is, but this is the way you have to find the answer. Okay, did plus live, lived. So they lived in a cave made out of a rock. Okay, how was it divided? So what is the tense here? Was divided is the tense. Now here it is the subject, right? It first, so always subject should be in the first layer. So write it first. So next you have to use the same tense from the question, same verb. Okay, it was divided, it was divided into, what is the answer? It was divided into several apartments. Okay, so actually this is a simple passage, you are getting all the direct answers. Anyhow, let us see. How, what did Prospero keep in one of his apartments? So in one of his apartments, what he had kept? He had kept his books. What books? Which chiefly treated of magic. So magic books. So simply you should not write, there he kept his books which chiefly treated of magic. You should not write the same sentence as it is. Okay. So what did Prospero keep? What is the verb here? Again, didn't keep is the verb. So what is did plus keep? Did plus keep is kept. Right. So he kept his books which chiefly treated of magic. Or you can write he kept his magic books. That is also correct. Okay. Now let us go for the next question. How did he release many good spirits? Okay, how did he release many? What is the verb here? Did release. What is did plus release? It is released. Okay, so in answer what you should use? You should use released. So released can be again splitted into did plus release. Did plus release is released. So both the tenses are same. So he released many good spirits by virtue of his art. See here, by virtue of his art, he had released many good. Or you can write, by virtue of his art, he released many good spirits. That is, he had also you can use. He had released many good spirits. If you want to write as it is, no problem, you can use. Okay. See the next E question. Who was the chief of all the spirits? So what is the verb here? So what is the verb? Was is the verb. So what is the answer? Ariel was the chief of all the spirits. Okay. So this is how you have to identify the answer. So verb in the question and verb in the answer, both in the question and in the answer, verb should be same, then only your answer will be correct without any grammar mistakes. You have to make sentence without any grammatical errors. So it is possible only if you use the proper verb, right? Actually this is a very simple passage. Okay, so it will be very easy for you to understand. Let us go for the next passage. See, so you read this passage yourself. It will be in your book also. So you can read this passage yourself. Now see the first question. Who gave the lively description of the storm? So here what is the verb? Gave is the verb. No need of cutting, editing and all. Okay, you can use it as it is. Ariel gave the. Who gave the lively description? Ariel. So Ariel gave the lively description of the storm. Okay, what did Ferdinand do? So what is, where is the answer here? Find the answer. What did Ferdinand do? Ferdinand was the first person who leaped into the sea. Okay, so here no need to use this verb. Okay, so what did Ferdinand do? Or you can write the answer. So here did is the auxiliary verb and do is the main verb in this question, right? So here Ferdinand, what Ferdinand had done, he jumped into the, that is he leaped into the sea. So either you can write Ferdinand was the first person who leaped into the sea, or Ferdinand was the first to leap into the sea. Or you can write, Ferdinand leaped into the sea. Okay. So this was his action. What did Ferdinand do? Do அப்படிங்கிறது என்ன, இட் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு ஹிஸ் ஆக்ஷன். ஸோ வாட் ஆக்ஷன் ஹீ ஹேட் டன்? ஹீ ஹேட் ஜம்ப்ட் இன் டு த சீ. ஸோ லீப்ட் இன் டு த சீ, ஜம்ப்ட் இன் டு த சீ, தட் இஸ் திஸ் இஸ் த ஆக்ஷன் ஹீ ஹேட் டன் ஹியர் இல்லையா. ஸோ லீப்ட் கேன் பி ஸ்பிளிட் இன் டு டிட் ப்ளஸ் லீப். ஓகே, டிட் ப்ளஸ் லீப். ஸோ வி காட் டிட், சி ஹியர் இட் இஸ் டிட், ஹியர் இட் இஸ் டிட். So what he did he do? He leaped into the, leap into the sea. So inga do form la verb irukku, inga leap um enna form da, do form da. So did plus inga do ngiradhu avan pannina action, the action he had done. So what action he had done? Leaping, jumping into the sea. So see here, did do, do enna form, adu present verb, do form la irukku. So leap um, it is leap is do form da, leap on do form da. So did plus leap, leaped, we got the answer. Do you understand? See, all this will be getting perfect only by your practice. It will not come in a single day, oru naal la illa vandradu. Only if you practice, write and practice lot, you can be perfect. Now see, what did the king of Naples think? So first of all, you have to identify the verb. That is the foremost thing you have to do. First you should identify the verb. So what is the verb here? Did think. So what is did plus think? Thought. நிறைய பேர் இதை மிஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணிப்பீங்க. டாட்னு, ஓகே, TAUGHT, thought. Taught எப்படி ஸ்பிளிட் பண்ணலாம்? டிட் ப்ளஸ் டீச் தான் தாட். ஸோ மெனி ஆஃப் யூ வில் ஹாவ் கன்ஃபியூஷன் பிட்வீன் டாட் அண்ட் தாட். யூ ஷுட் நாட் கன்ஃபியூஸ் பிட்வீன் தீஸ் டூ. திஸ் இஸ் டிட் ப்ளஸ் டீச் இஸ் டாட், டிட் ப்ளஸ் திங்க் இஸ் தாட். ஓகே, ஸோ வாட் டிட் த கிங் ஆஃப் நேபல்ஸ் திங்க்? ஹீ தாட், டிட் ப்ளஸ் திங்க், தாட். Okay, so he thought that his dear son was. So these answers you can find here. I am just explaining. It is easy to identify the answer from the passage. Passage lernthu answer kandupidikirathu, it is very very easy. The only thing is in the first area you should write without any grammar mistake. That is the problem you will be facing. நான் இப்போ ஆன்சர் எப்படி கண்டுபிடிக்கிறதுன்னு ஐ எம் நாட் எக்ஸ்பிளைனிங், பிகாஸ் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஆஃப் யூ கேன் ஈஸிலி ஐடென்டிஃபை த ஆன்சர். த ஒன்லி திங் இஸ் ஹவு டு மேக் சென்டென்ஸ் வித்தவுட் கிராமர் மிஸ்டேக். ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், வாஸ் த கிங் ஆஃப் நேபிள்ஸ் சேஃப்? வாஸ் த கிங் ஆஃப் நேபிள்ஸ் சேஃப்? சி, திஸ் க்வெஸ்டன் இஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஃப்ரம் ஏ, பி, சி அண்ட் இ. சி, திஸ் ஆல் பிகின்ஸ் வித் ஹூ, வாட், வாட், what. So these are WH questions, that is interrogative questions. WH interrogative questions can be split into two, WH and SR no type, right? So these are WH questions. Here, was the king of Naples safe? So here was is an auxiliary verb, right? So if a question begins with an auxiliary verb, it is called as yes or no question. All the yes or no questions will begin with an auxiliary verb. Okay, so if a yes or no question is beginning with an auxiliary verb, the answer should also begin with yes or no. Okay, answer also should begin with yes or no. So for all the yes or no questions, first you have to write yes or no, right? See, was the king of Naples safe? So it is a yes or no question, since it is beginning with the auxiliary verb was. So you have to write either yes or no. Here it is yes. Yes, the king of Naples safe. You have to put a comma here. Yes, the king of Naples was safe. See, was you can use as it is. Yes, the king of Naples was safe. Understand? See the next one. What happened to the ship? So what is the verb here? Happened is the verb. Okay, what happened to the ship? So in this question, that is for this question, we cannot write the verb happened as it is. The happened to the ship appadila eludha mudiyuma? No, it will be wrong. Definitely it will be wrong. So here what is the tense? It is past tense. It is in past tense. So the answer should also be in past tense. What happened to the ship? The ship is it is safe in the harbor, illaya? So the see, in the passage it is ease. Okay, because there Ariel is giving a lively description, that's why she is using ease there. But in our question it is past tense, so you should not use present tense here. The answer also should be past. So the question is in past tense, so answer is also in the past tense. What happened to the ship? The ship was safe in the harbor. Can you understand? Now let us go further. So see, in the first passage we did not have any yes or no questions. We didn't face such such questions, such doubts there. See, in this passage this question is different, illaya? So you are learning something new in this question. So andha madri da, only if you practice you can get perfection. You have to practice a lot for all the own topics to write without any grammar mistakes. You have to practice a lot. First of all, written practice will be very much helpful. Now see this passage. So this passage you can read yourself. Let me go for the question part. Who answered timidly? So what is the verb here? Answered. So Miranda answered. Here we can use it as it is. Why was Prospero well pleased? See, whenever you are getting why, the answer should be a reason. Okay, so why was Prospero well pleased? So here also you can use the verb was as it is. He was well pleased to find they admired each other. Okay, why was Prospero harsh towards Ferdinand? So here was, here also you can use it as it is. What did he resolve to do? So what is the verb here? Did resolve, illaya? So here did resolve. Inga to do is not a verb, it is an infinitive. To plus verb is an infinitive. So he resolved. So did plus resolve, resolved. Listen, to plus do, to plus verb is an infinitive. So did plus resolve is the verb here. To plus do we cannot take it as a verb because it is infinitive. So did plus resolve, resolved. So to do, enna pannana, throw some difficulties in their way. So to see, and the do can answer throw. Okay, do can answer in the, it is throw. So he did plus resolve, resolved to do. Enna do? Doing what? Doing is happening. Throw. Okay, throw some difficulties in their way. Understand? So this question is different in this. You have to understand clearly. See the next one. What did Prospero do to Ferdinand by his magic wand? See, what is the verb here? Can you identify? Did do is the verb. So this type of question we have seen earlier. Yeah? Did plus do is the verb. So by waving his magic wand, Prospero fixed Ferdinand to the spot. So what work he had done? So na munna idu pannom illaya, so we have seen earlier. Like this you can try this yourself. Okay, you try the pass pannittu neengala try panni verb match pannittu. If you can't understand, listen to the video again. Okay, see, fixed is the verb here. Did plus do kan answer inga enna na fixed. Fixed can be splitted into did plus fix, illaya? fixed can be splitted into did plus fix. So did do, what doing? Fixing. Can you understand? So did is matched, do ku fix is matched. Can you understand? Listen, did plus fix, did plus fix. So for did is matched, what doing? Fix. Work done is fixing. So did plus fix, fixed. We got the answer same as question, both are matched, right? So this is how you have to answer the passage comprehension question. So this is just example. What is given in your guide is just an example. So this lesson is such a, it is a little bit big lesson, having some 2-4 more than 5 pages, I think. So there are many passage comprehension questions are possible. So whatever question is asked, you have to answer clearly, avoiding grammar mistakes. Okay, way to success students, if you don't have passage comprehension in your guide, you can follow this. It is an example. Whoever it is, you can follow this. So this is how you have to answer the passage comprehension questions without any grammar mistake. It is just an example. Many such passage comprehensions are possible from your book. Okay, so listen and understand properly. Thank you. Let us see in the next class. Thank you for watching. Thank you.